Yeah, there's flying glaciers and Mox Emerald. Yeah, I like this hand. I mean, if he doesn't have a library, then we're okay. And off to the races. Play Stomping Ground tap, then play Emerald, then Thaw for a swamp, and then next turn replay this, or we can play. Yeah, we could just play this for one. I kind of want to save this for a good all's dust, so I'm gonna go ahead and play. Just play that. What is going on? Stomping Ground, Mox Emerald. This is a blue-black deck. So if we get the swamp, we can cast Dreadboard, replay Thawing Glaciers, Vindicate. Sure. Don't actually care about that. You should have Vindicated Thawing Glaciers. We're still gonna get a swamp. Smash the Smithereens. In the past, I kind of want to play this for more, so I can wait. Just want to play the waiting game. This Everflowing Chalice is going to be big, so we just got to make sure that we don't die to something like Nicol Bolas. Factor Fiction. Man. Now I kind of want to play it. And we can play it for two next turn. Or we can wait and play Foff and then play a big one. Oh boy. That was a good draw. So we still need to go for more black, I think. Mox Jet, huh? Well, we can play it for two. Play Mountain, play this for two, then play Mox Jet, then play Foff. Yeah, I like that. Maybe we should have been looking for a Spectre or some sort of discard. He's just going to draw, and that's going to suck. Good job vindicating my Stomping Grounds. Ugh. Yep, we can look for Liliana, look for some other stuff. Oh, and he's going down to six. Yes, excellent. Ajani. Okay. Mountain. Mox Emerald. No. We can always clone it with this if we really want to. Or just all his dust. I think I'm gonna Foff, look for a Hymn to Tauroc. And Aeon Chronicler. I guess that's fine. Treachery, Aeon Chronicler. A lot of this stuff just doesn't do anything. I'm gonna suspend a fat Aeon Chronicler this turn. Alright, basically, I'm going to. I need to find a bunch of discards, so I'm just gonna go for the Aeon Chronicler. You can just like Mystic Snake Treachery, yeah, but Treachery just doesn't seem that great against his deck, and Mystic Snake is good, but we have more counters, so I want to actually just draw a bunch of cards. So we can suspend for three because this isn't going to untap. And we've got blue, three, four. Then Emerald Jet. Or Emerald Swamp for three. Ooh, Hymn to Tauroc. Well, I guess we're not doing that now. So we can just Hymn him to keep him off of LOA. Play our Simic Signet. And then Scourge Magma Jet Helix. Ugh, that is terrible. We'll play Simic Signet and Thawing Glaciers. We can't cast any of our spells. Need another mountain. All right, we can. Okay, so he's gonna let our mountain untap, which is good. So we can dreadbore that thing. And then, let's see if he wants to just pass for two turns. Okay, it looks like he's gonna go off the LOA, which is good. That's really what we want. Orzhov Signet? Sure. One, so he's got two, three, four, five, six, seven. Batterskull. Well, this is gonna be a good turn. So we just gotta smash the Batterskull now. Cryptic Command, we can't quite cast that yet, so we can do three to Ajani, so depending on how soon we think that that's gonna, I think doing that is gonna be good. So we'll redirect some damage to Ajani. Then, I guess we don't need anything else. We can't get any red mana, so we're just gonna go ahead and pass the turn. Fetch out some blue, and then be able to cast Cryptic Command. Hopefully, like if he, well, we'll just have to wait and see. Flowing Chalice again. Yeah, so I think he's just ramping up for a Nicol Bolas. So we'll go ahead and fetch out some blue. And then, let's see, go from there. Hero's Downfall. Okay, so I think we're probably pretty safe from that since he'll, if he plays Nicol Bolas, we can just all his dust, so I'm pretty comfortable with suspending this for a lot. For four? Yeah, should be good. And he's probably gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then, like, if he blows up our mountain, that's gonna suck. We'd have to play, let's see, we'd have to copy a Boros Signet, I think, because Painted Prism doesn't come onto the battlefield with any counters if we were to metamorph it. Hopefully this is just an Elspeth. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This looks like Nicol Bolas to me, for sure. So we'll see what he does. Might just kill Thawing Glaciers, to be honest. Might just lock down Thawing Glaciers. Yep, that resolves. And you can't stand getting rid of the value, huh? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we'll be able to, if we draw a land, then we can cast All's Dust and use our Thawing Glaciers. Probably would have just gotten rid of this mountain. I mean, this mountain has to be trouble. Like he can just Ajani the Everflowing Chalice. Yeah, that's just bad on his part, I think. Let's just draw something. Something's pretty sweet. Land, that's good enough. So I guess we'll just get rid of this now. Boom. We call forth a sacrifice. And so this game is gonna be getting out of hand now. He's got nothing, so we'll go ahead and thaw, get some more blue out. We've got three cards left, so we'll go ahead and just get more blue. And then we can play Garrick, and he doesn't have the Lightning Helix anymore, but he has Shriekmaw. That gets Underground Sea. Actually, kind of like playing Liliana Vest and just ticking it up. So we'll go one, two. And then we can make him discard a card. So this library is staying off forever. And we don't need to play Garrick now. We can just play Thawing Glaciers again. Right. So he's got land in his hand. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 mana. And nothing for him. All right. Well, we're gonna draw some more cards. We have to. Okay, so we've got one forest left. Force of Will. 10. So we can actually just play this and. Well, first uptick. Play Garrick and then start making dudes. Then we have some guys. Yeah, so this should be good. Pretty good spot right now. Two hard counters, plus a way to fight something small and chain lightning. How do I feel about that? That's killing Garrick. That's fine. Don't really care too much about that. And we're not gonna redirect. Garrick, you were dead for the horde. So let's fetch out this last forest. And this underground sea. And Thawing Glaciers returns to our hand. We're gonna draw some extra cards, hit with this huge Aeon Chronicler, have two counter spells. And I can't imagine that he'll be able to do anything that will be able to get him through that turn. Plus, if he plays any creatures, we have Hero's Downfall and Dreadbore. So yeah. And Bonfire. Would we like to reveal it? No. For its miracle cost, how much would that be for? So, be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? Sure. I guess we can do it. You've drawn a miracle card. Would you like to reveal it? Sure. I guess that was a pretty good time to do it. So we can foul, and so it's basically. Seven, let's see. So, one, two. So we draw step. So we'll have still eight cards. So this will be 8, 10. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That should be enough. Okay. Cast the miracle from your hand. So target him. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Boom. Then cast this guy. Tick, so it'll be one card and left Force of Will is a draw. Yeah, not bad, I suppose. Go for the throat. I think I will counter that. Do I have to counter that? Yeah, I probably have to counter that. What happens? Yeah, we'll just counter that. So he goes at 2. 1. I guess this leaves us a little vulnerable. He's a 1 life. And we have a Liliana on 8. Yeah, I guess we just didn't need to reveal that. We'd 4, so we'd still have Cryptic Command. Yeah. Let's see, what creatures does he have? 0. Just the way I like it. Wrath of God. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to uptick and then get our Chronicler back. 6 cards. So it should be okay. We get Mystic Snake. Yeah. And we don't have any lands left, so there's no point in playing Flying Glaciers. So we'll just make him discard a card and Hypnotic Spectre. And that should be good. He's on nothing. We have outdrawn the library. And that's it. Off to round 3. Yes, excellent.